That Lakota East teacher is now under investigation.
Because police say money students paid for prom tickets disappeared. News 5's Karen Johnson is live tonight getting you answers. It's new at 5:30. Karen?
Well, Jack, we're talking about $760, according to this police report, which we got our hands on today. Not a whole lot of money, but enough for the Butler County Sheriff's Office to launch an investigation.
Yeah, I just gave her some of my money when she promised that she'll give it to prom, but she never really did.
Nibea Fry, one of several Lakota East students who says she paid for her prom ticket only for the money to go missing, possibly into the pocket of a teacher who was in charge of the senior celebration that was held here at the Savannah Center.
It's really sad and disappointing because everybody looked up to her a lot, and we like really, really liked her. That's why we always like trusted her so much, and for her to do that, it kind of like breaks my heart.
News 5 is not naming the teacher because she has not yet been charged, but we have confirmed she is under investigation after an administrator at Lakota East filed a police report. It reads, the staff member in charge of the prom had been conducting ticket sales from her room, and the money was never placed into the prom account.
I mean, I didn't think a teacher would do that. It was more of a student thing, I think, would do that.
Students say she was a well-liked and well-respected teacher. Many are hoping this turns out to be nothing more than an honest mistake.
I mean, you don't want to see something like that happen, especially in the school where, you know, all the adults are supposed to be responsible. And, you know, hopefully she's not, you know, setting a bad example on purpose.
And I did confirm with Lakota East High School that that teacher was not in school today. The district, however, will not confirm whether she resigned or not. The district also has not gotten back to me about my public information request. Reporting live tonight in Liberty Township, Karen Johnson, News 5.